Welcome to another Revel University video tutorial. This video will cover employees in Revel and will highlight how to add employees manually or in bulk, as well as setting up roles and permissions for your users. As with all of our tutorials, you can jump ahead to any topic that is most important to you. All of our tutorials have a table of contents, and you can use the time bar at the bottom of the video to get to a new section. So let's get started with the basics of adding employees in the Management Console. On the Employees tab, if you have employees, those will be listed on this page. You can easily edit an existing employee by clicking on the Actions icon. However, before we go into detail about adding employees, let's look at roles and permissions, since these have to be set up before you add employees. On the left, just like on the Products tab, you see an additional menu for employee options. The Employees tab is where you'll find your existing employees, the screen that we just saw. Next, you have the Roles option, which allows you to create roles for your employees on the point of sale. Once your roles are created, then you can manage each role's POS permissions. And finally, there's a separate option for Management Console permissions in case you want to grant someone else access to the Management Console. So let's take a quick look at how to create new roles. By default, your Management Console will have a few default roles depending on your business type. If you want to edit an existing role, click the role name and relabel it accordingly. Each role will also have an option to assign it to a department. This is useful for labor tracking purposes to help determine labor across various departments. For example, a QSR or TSR setup might create a department for front of house and one for back of house. Then, in your labor reports, you can determine if you have the flexibility to send an employee home in one of the departments, or if you need to staff those departments more heavily. You can choose from the drop-down of departments that have already been created, or if you need to add a new department, click on plus add new at the top of the list. Next, you can set the role's rank, which will help you create a hierarchy of POS permissions ranking between 1 and 999. So again, think of ranking as a hierarchy of permissions. So if your establishment has shift supervisors and managers, if your shift supervisor has a lower rank than your managers, they will not be able to edit roles of anyone with a higher rank. For more info on ranking, be sure to review our full help article on rank and tiered permissions linked below. As with products, the active checkbox indicates whether or not the role displays and can be assigned to an employee. Next, we have the ability to copy roles, which you can also do on the POS Permissions tab. And here's a quick pro tip on roles and permissions. If you've already set up the permissions for one role, it's easiest to copy the entire role and then go in and edit the permissions for the new role. So if you have two roles that will have very similar access on the point of sale, such as a server and a bartender, create the first role, set up your permissions, and then copy that role. When you duplicate a role, it will be labeled as a copy. Click the role name to name it appropriately. To add a brand new role, click the plus add button and choose add role from the dropdown, or use the plus role at the bottom. Enter the name of the role and choose the department and rank. Repeat this process until all of your required roles are added. Always be sure to save when finished. After your roles have been created, you'll need to assign permissions to each role. This will determine what each role has access to on the point of sale. To manage permissions, click the POS Permissions option. All of your active roles are displayed across the top of the matrix. If you'd like, you can filter the roles that appear on the page by clicking the View All Departments box and then choosing a department from the dropdown. Only the roles saved under that department will be displayed. You can create a new role from here as well, but only by copying an existing role. Just choose the role you want to copy. The new role will be labeled as a copy of the initial role. To change the name, you'll need to update on the POS Roles tab. As you can see, there are a lot of permissions available in the system. This is why it is easier to set up one role and its permissions and then copy that role for similar roles. When you copy the role, it copies all of the permissions as well, so it's much easier than starting from scratch on a new role. All of the role permissions show in the left column. To see further explanations of each permission, hover over the question mark until the details box appears. Again, the permission selected for a specific role will affect the amount of access an employee has on the point of sale. For instance, you can see by default, the owner and manager roles will have access to every permission, while the employee role has very limited access. To assign or unassign a permission to a role, simply click the appropriate box in the matrix. For example, clicking this box grants permission to the employee role to void items. Assign permissions accordingly and save to finalize your changes. Now that we've covered POS permissions in detail, let's discuss Management Console permissions. Management Console permissions are necessary for any employee that will be accessing the Management Console. This could be owners, managers, accountants, or any other employees that are responsible for inputting or viewing data in Revel. To create a new permission set, click Management Console Permissions. Your Management Console will have some default administrator permission sets. You can use the included sets or create brand new ones that include specific permissions. The All Permissions set is generally assigned to owners and managers. This will grant the user access to every tab in the Management Console. The Read set allows the user to see everything, but will not allow them to edit or add any information. If you want to edit an existing set, click on the pencil icon. If you want to create a new permission set from scratch, start by clicking the plus add button and then choose new administrator permission set. First, type in the name of the set. Then on the left, check all the Management Console tabs this set will have access to. Note that checking the box on the left only displays the permissions. It does not grant the level of access to those items. That is done on the right. Notice the different icons that appear above the matrix. The book icon will grant read-only permission, the pencil icon will grant editing permission, and the plus icon will grant permission to add new data. The key icon is only for enterprise management, so you may not see this option in your account. If there is a specific field that you want to prohibit in the set, make sure the no icon is selected for that item. For instance, you may want to prohibit access to wage details or other sensitive information. Once you have selected all applicable permissions, be sure to save your changes. Now that we have our permissions set, let's add an employee so you can see how to assign both the role permissions and the Management Console permissions to your employees. To add a new employee, click the Employees tab. We saw this at the beginning of the tutorial as this is the landing page for the Employees tab and is where you can add or edit employees. If you don't have any employees in the system yet, you can click on the Add Employees button or click the Bulk Employee Import at the bottom. We'll learn more about bulk importing in a bit. On this page, you'll input all the information for the employee. The required fields are marked with an asterisk. Start by filling out the employee's first and last name. The employee's start field will populate with today's date, but you can update this to the employee's accurate start date. Next, enter the initial role. Choose the most appropriate starting role for the employee. If the employee will have multiple roles, such as a waiter and a bartender, you can assign additional roles and wages after the employee is saved in the system. Next, either input or generate a PIN. This will be the number the employee uses to log in or clock in on the point of sale. The PIN must be unique for each employee and between 4 and 10 digits. Fill out any additional information in the top section. Some of the fields that are not required but are very helpful include things like the employee's email address, which allows you to email an employee their schedule if you use the scheduling system. Or the starting wage field is important if you plan on using Revel's payroll functionality. Here, you'll enter the employee's starting hourly wage. If the employee only needs access to the point of sale, then you only need to fill out the required fields in the employee details and POS permissions section. However, if the employee should also have access to the management console, be sure to expand this section. Start by creating a username for the employee, which is what they will use to log into the management console and must be unique for each employee. Next, enter the employee's email address and create a password for the employee and confirm it. Again, this will be used at each login and can be changed by the employee when they first log in. The last option here is to grant the level of access the user should have to the management console. Choose from the dropdown that we saw previously. Whatever restrictions you set for each permission is what the user can and cannot do in the system. After you have filled out all the required information and any additional fields you want, click Save and Close to leave the screen, or Save and New if you would like to add another employee. If there are any errors in your input, the screen will remain on the page. The issues will display beneath the corresponding field. If this happens, correct the error and click either of the Save options. If the system detects a duplicate PIN, a new window will appear titled Possible Duplicate after you click one of the Save options. The only time you would link an employee to an existing PIN would be if you had multiple locations and you needed the same employee attached to multiple establishments. If there are no errors, you'll be taken back to the main employee screen where you'll see your newly added employee. You can use this method to add or edit your employee profiles at any time. After you initially add an employee to the system, if you need to edit their information, click on the Actions button next to their name. You'll notice additional options appear on the screen. We won't go through every option here, but be sure to check out our employee details article linked below for a full overview. On the details page, this is where you can assign additional roles to an employee. So if an employee will sometimes clock in as a server and other times as a bartender, you can add each role along with the appropriate wage. Scroll to the Roles and Wages section and select the additional role from the dropdown. If you are using Revel to track payroll, input the wage for the role. Another thing to note here, under the Administrative Permissions section, there's a checkbox to grant EMS access. If your business has multiple locations and you are using Revel's Enterprise Management System, if you want the administrator to be able to access multiple locations, be sure to check the EMS box. You can also manage establishment access to grant access to additional locations. Once you are done saving the additional employee details, be sure to save. Also, make sure to refresh the point of sale for any changes to take effect. If you just have a few employees to add, you can easily do so using the previous method. However, if you have a lot of employees that you want to add or edit in bulk, you can do this using the employee import/export. First, you'll need to export the required template by clicking the ellipsis icon and selecting Import/Export. From here, choose the export type. The advanced option will include more employee details than basic, while the empty template will export an advanced template with no employee data in the file. If you choose an advanced or basic export, you will need to select the employee status, choose from one of the status options.
I'll choose current and then click the export button.
Now open your Excel file to start inputting your employee information. The required fields are the employee's last name, first name, roles, PIN, employee start date, and the active status. After you have filled out all required fields, you can enter any additional information that applies. Save the file when finished. Now you need to import the file to add your employees. From the same import-export screen, you'll import the file at the bottom. Click on the Choose File button and select the Excel template you just saved. After the screen indicates that the file is attached, click the Import button. You will see a message appear in yellow at the bottom of the screen. This is alerting you that the upload is an offline process. You will receive an email once the upload is complete. The email will advise whether your employees were successfully imported, changed, or if any errors occurred. If the file shows errors, fix the issues in the template and upload again. Now, are you ready to see how employees interact with the POS? Let's take a look. On the point of sale home screen, if you've recently added a new employee, be sure to first refresh the point of sale for them to be able to access it. After the refresh completes, now the employee can log in and/or clock in on the home screen. First, they'll enter their PIN and choose login or clock in. Clock in, clock out will be used if you are using Revel for payroll tracking. Remember how we set the roles for employees and entered their wages for each role? When I clock this employee in, notice I'm prompted to clock in for the appropriate role. This will determine the employee's hourly rate for this shift. Once we're clocked in, now we can log in to start creating orders. I'll enter the same PIN and select login. Now the employee will have access only to the permissions granted when we set up our roles and permissions. And it shows the employee that's logged in at the top right with their name. Some fields may still appear as options, but if the employee doesn't have access, they'll be prompted for a manager's PIN. But let's not get too ahead of ourselves here on the point of sale. We'll learn more about the POS and all its functions in a separate tutorial. As you can see, Revel offers many options for adding, editing, and managing your employees. We hope you were able to follow along and complete the necessary steps. If you have any additional questions, please visit the related knowledge base articles on our support site. Thank you for watching another Revel University video tutorial.